Hello everybody, you're listening to Breakfast with Alfred. I'm your host, Pastor Alfred. Breakfast with Alfred is a series of audio broadcasts where I highlight certain portions of information in books that I'm currently writing or books that are already published. To get more books from me, you have to subscribe to PastorAlfred.com so that you'll get alerts when my new books are out. And also, do well to look into currently existing books that I've already published and see which books have information that are of extreme importance to you. Today, I would like to sort of take on the second part of kicking off the Christmas series, where I'll be saying something about Christmas every day during this Yuletide period. Today I would like to tell you that a Christmas card is not a gift. If you are somebody who has been listening to me for a while, I'm sure that you must have heard me say something like this before. Today, I really want to expand on it and let you see that really a Christmas card is not a gift. Let's look at the book of 2 Samuel chapter 24, verse 24. I'm looking at the King James Version of the Bible. And the king said unto Arunah, Nay, but I will surely buy it of thee at a price. Neither will I offer burnt offering unto the Lord my God of that which cost me nothing. So David bought the threshing floor and the oxen for 50 shekels of silver. Praise the Lord. So you see, you cannot give somebody a gift that does not cost you anything. In this personal scripture, David is making a point that he cannot offer a burnt offering to God that does not cost him anything. It's ludicrous. He cannot offer a sacrifice to God that somebody else gives to you for free. So David is making this point, and this point applies to everything else. Even outside of giving a gift to God, when we are giving a gift to a human being, the value of that gift speaks of how much you, that person is of value to you. Look at the relationship between man and God. When God wanted to give to man, what did he give? He gave his only begotten son. That shows the value of man to God. The value of the gift that was given. He gave the life of his own son. Can you imagine how precious that is? That is actually the most precious thing to God. God gave his best to man. You know, and when you are giving gifts, you must understand that the value is the key factor on which everything is surrounded when it comes to giving gifts. If someone is so important to you, if someone is of value to you, how can you just give that person a Christmas card? A Christmas card is something that has become somewhat automated through secretaries. You just create a list and then assign or delegate a secretary or somebody else that is in your organization to just mail out the Christmas cards to respective people. No, that is not how it is done for people you really value. When someone sends you a Christmas card only, what does that tell you? You know that that person does not consider you high on their list of people that are of extreme importance to them. They didn't give their closest friends just Christmas cards. And if they did, that person is actually a very unfortunate and selfish person. Christmas is something that you should plan for. It's an important season that, with the grace of God, will never go away. And you must understand the traditions and develop good and positive Christ-based traditions around Christmas. And one of the beautiful things about Christmas is that Christmas gives us an excuse to sow into the life of any and everybody. People expect to be given gifts and receive gifts at Christmas, which is not the case with any other time. If you give certain people gifts, you cannot give certain co-workers a random gift. You cannot even give certain co-workers gifts on their birthdays because you've never talked to them before. But during Christmas time, there's a spirit of giving in the air. So somebody you've never spoken to before, or somebody that doesn't even know you, it is still appropriate and it is still accepted and it's still within the realms of etiquette, well approved for anybody to exchange gifts during Christmas period. So you should plan it, and your priorities must be clear. You must leave the realm of giving out Christmas cards to giving out real gifts. You should be somebody that pays attention to people. So when they are living their life, you should see their needs or their wants or things that will improve their life. For example, if you go to a friend's house and you observe that after dinner, the wife has to do the dishes herself by hand, or the kids have to do the dishes themselves by hand, or it was just stacked there to be done later. You have observed that they do not have a dishwasher. So you can get them a dishwasher for Christmas. You know, you should look out for people's needs and wants. And this is something that will even help you in business. And this is why some people never go forward in business, because they are not constantly conscious of the needs and wants of people around them. So they are not aware of certain markets that are around them, markets that they can provide products and services to that would be of benefit to them. There is also the important factor of creating handwritten notes. Handwritten notes means so much, and you must understand that it is extremely valuable. Even though we live in a digital world, there is something about the handwritten notes that still has something that cannot be conveyed online via emails or text messages or other digital means. If you must give out a Christmas card, buy a Christmas card that the inside is blank, so you write your handwritten notes inside. Or we all have printers in our homes or place of work or somewhere that is accessible to us. So print out your own card, create your own custom card. You can easily do it. There are a lot of software that will help you to do the formatting. So all you need to do is to add pictures and add whatever written text that you want to write and then print it out. Even at that, I would still say that if you are printing it out, you should only print out the cover, but let the inside be your handwritten notes. Even though you have the ability to use digital text before printing, you know. So for more information about this, you have to go to pastoralfred.com and subscribe so that you receive alerts of new books that I have coming out, and also get books that are already published. I'll also like you to check out pastoralfred.com/clothing to check out my clothing line. There are a lot of designs and clothing products that are out there on the sites that you can buy no matter where you are in the world, that I'm sure you would really like. They will make great Christmas gifts during this yellow tide period. Once again, thank you and God bless you.